Hello students, hope you all are doing great. I am Achal Chaudhary, working as an assistant professor in BBA department in St. Andrew's Institute of Technology and Management, Gurugram. So today I am sharing a lecture on company accounts to help you with your exams. So first of all, let's start with the benefits of this video. Why you should watch this video? Well, let's start with the subject content. Basically, it includes issue of shares and debentures, buyback of shares, acquisition of business, underwriting, final accounts, accounting standards, valuation of goodwill and shares, and banking and insurance company accounts. So we will be covering all the topics one by one. Next, talking about the topics. So today we will be discussing about final accounts and its statutory provisions and what are adjustment entries. Next, also in between, I will be discussing some important points or some important questions which can be asked in your exams. So we will be discussing in between of the videos. And we will also solve some numericals in the video for your better understanding. Also, I will be sharing some unsolved numericals with you, unsolved questions with you, so that you can have a practice. And in the end of every video, I will be sharing some questions with you which has been asked in university exams previously. So that you can have some insights about the questions pattern, like what can be asked in exams from a particular topic, right? So let's start with our final accounts. So let's start with the final accounts. What are final accounts? Basically, it's an account which are prepared at the end stage of an accounting year. This account highlights both the financial position and profits of a business, which can be used by any investor or internal bodies for various reasons. So students, basically, why we prepare final accounts? The reason behind that is to know the profitability of the business, like how much profit a company is earning right now, and also to know the financial strength of a company, to forecast and to for the like purpose of budgeting. And also it has a main feature, it has a main motive behind final accounts, that is to analyze the growth rate of business. So in final accounts we prepare three statements, that are trading account, P&L account and balance sheet. So let's understand all of three in details. So first is your trading account. It is an account that is prepared by the entities to know the profit earned or loss suffered from the trading activities. Students, it is the first stage of the final account. It also includes all the direct expenses related to the purchase of goods and sale of goods. And one more thing, it is only concerned with the current year expenses. No previous year or next year expenses are included in trading account. So students, mark this point, that it only includes current year's expenses. So let's have a look on the format of the trading account. Students, this is the format of trading account. I just want to tell you one thing, that if you remember the formats, then 60% of the work is done. Then all you have to focus on posting the transactions and evaluating the adjustment entries. So as we can see in the format, it always starts from the opening stock, that is being recorded in debit side, and in credit side it ends up with the closing stock. So one more thing, I have noticed that many of you records the purchase return in credit side. So for those students, please follow this particular format. It will be deducted from purchase account only. There is nothing like that that is wrong pattern or the right one. There is nothing like that. Answer will remain same in both the situation, but this is the correct format. So here all the expenses are recorded in debit side, and sales and closing stock will be recorded in credit side. So after posting all the transactions, whatever the remaining balance comes, that will be recorded in either in gross profit or gross loss account, and that will be directly transferred to the P&L account. Our next is your P&L account. Profit and loss account is an account created to ascertain the net profit or loss for the period. Basically, students, it's a financial statement that summarizes the revenues, costs, and expenses incurred during the accounting period. So basically, it only shows the indirect expenses and indirect revenues. All the revenues and expenses, whether received or paid in cash or not, all are recorded in this account. This is a specimen of profit and loss account. As you can see, it starts with the closing balance of trading account, that is profit, gross profit or gross loss. So gross loss is recorded in the debit side along with all the indirect expenses. Students, please note here we include only indirect expenses and indirect revenues. And it is, if there is a gross profit, that will be recorded in the credit side of P&L account along with all the indirect revenues. As you can see, rent received, miscellaneous received, interest received, these all are the indirect revenues. And the closing balance of P&L account is transferred to the balance sheet. Many times in exams, the difference between the two has been asked, the difference between the trading account and P&L account. So please prepare this difference chart so that you can write easily if it comes in your exam. First is, trading account focuses on the purchase and sale of products, whereas profit and loss account focuses on the representing the actual profit earned or loss sustained by the business. In trading account, we record and ascertain the gross profit, whereas in P&L account, we get net profit for the period. And whenever we transfer the balance of trading account, we transfer directly it to the P&L account, and the balance of P&L account is transferred to the capital account in balance sheet. And in trading accounts, direct revenues and direct expenses are recorded, whereas in P&L account, operating and non-operating incomes and expenses are recorded, which are indirect expenses and indirect revenues. After preparing trading account and P&L account, next is your balance sheet. So what is balance sheet? Basically, it's a financial statement that reports a company's assets, liabilities, and shareholders' equity. So students, it's a basically what we can conclude is that it's a statement that tells about the company's current financial position along with what a company owns and owes. A specimen of balance sheet. Here in debit side, as we can see, we record all the liabilities, which are like, first we focus on current liabilities, we record current liabilities, then non-current liabilities, then in last, we record capital. And from capital, whatever the profit, net profit or net loss is like summed up from the P&L account, that will be added here in capital account. If it is net profit, it will be added up. And if it is net loss, then it will be deducted from capital. And if we have any interest on capital, that will be added up here. And whatever the drawings we are having, that will be deducted from the capital account. And in credit side, first we record all the current assets, then non current or fixed assets are recorded there. Students, please mark one point that whatever the total of the balance sheet, like if the total of liability side is 2 lakh, then it is very mandatory that assets should be 2 lakh only. So both the liabilities and assets should be equal in number, like liability should be equals to asset side. Next is your adjustment entries. What are adjustment entries? Basically, these are the events. These are the events or transactions which has been occurred in the accounting period, but they were not recorded. Or you can say it is an end of period adjustment made to record prepaid expenses, unearned income, accrued expenses, accrued revenue, and non-cash activities. Basically, adjustment entries focuses on the matching principle, where matching principle states that expenses have to be matched to the accounting period in which the revenue paying for them is earned. So it will be matched accordingly. Some important terms which are observed in financial account, in final accounts. So let's discuss them one by one. First is your interest on debenture. Basically, it is an expense for a business as we pay it to the debenture holder. So it will be debited in the P&L account. Next is your income tax on interest on debenture. It is also a kind of payment only. It's an expense. Next is your interest on loan. Basically, loan is a liability for us. So interest on loan will also be an expense, which will be recorded in liability side of balance sheet and debit side of P&L account. Next is your closing stock. Basically, students, closing stock is the unsold items of goods that will remain in store only. So it will be shown on the asset side of the balance sheet, and also it is shown as a credit side of the trading account, as we have seen in the specimen of both the accounts. Next is your outstanding expenses. These are the kind of expenses which are incurred but not yet paid. So the treatment will be, it will be shown in liabilities side of the balance sheet and added up in the concerned item. Next is your accrued income. Accrued income are those income that are earned but not received. Means the amount has not been received yet. So it will be shown in the asset side of the balance sheet and added to the concerned item. Next is your prepaid expenses. These are the expenses that are paid in advance. Means you have not earned any kind of service on that behalf, but you have paid the expenses in like today scenario only. You are paying the expenses for tomorrow. So this will be your prepaid expenses. So these are shown in the asset sides, and also these are deducted from the concerned item. Advance income. Advance income are those type of income which are not earned but yet received in advance. So it is kind of a liabilities for us. So it will be shown in the liability side of the balance sheet and deducted from the concerned item. Next is your depreciation. Basically, depreciation is the regularly reduction of the value of assets. So it is deducted from the concerned assets in the asset side and shown in the debit side of P&L account. Next is your bad debts and provision for bad debts. Student, bad debts is an amount which we don't expect that we will receive this amount in future. So we just expect that we are having a bad debt, we are not going to receive any amount for that. Like for if we have given some loan to a person, so we know that he is not well settled. He is not financially stable, so he will not be able to pay us that amount. So we consider that amount as a bad debt. So while making a provision for bad debts, that will be known as provision for bad debts account. So it is deducted from the asset side, and in debit in P&L account it is shown in the debit side. Next is your interest on capital. Interest on capital is a kind of interest we receive on capital. So it's a kind of expense for us. So it will be added to the capital account in the balance sheet. Next is your statutory provisions regarding preparation of company's final accounts. So according to the Companies Act 2013, we have to maintain a books of accounts. So here are some transactions which we have to record in books of accounts according to the statutory provisions, which are all sums of money received and expended by a company, all sales and purchases of goods and services, the assets and liabilities of a company, the items of a cost as may be prescribed by the section 148. So these four items are included in the books of accounts. So as I said, here is the important question which has been asked in university exam. So let's have a look on that. What do you mean by final accounts? Why adjustment entries are required to be made at the time of preparing final accounts? And also you have to give illustrative examples of such adjustment entries. I know you can solve this question, so please try to solve it. And I hope you all are clear with the today's topic. Students, one more thing. If you have any doubt or any query, so we can conduct a meeting over Google Meet app to solve all your queries. So if you face some difficulties, do let me know. Okay. Thank you so much for your cooperation and your interest. Stay tuned for more videos.